All right, so we're talking commercial here. I have to make commercial. Remember this? Oh my gosh, I did have this one dude that I danced with. He spoke this way in his English. I loved him. Make commercial. Yeah, they'd be like this. Yeah, but anyway, here is this. Oh my gosh, it's mine. I made it. But this is the first edition. I made another one. I don't think you call it the edition. It's more like a fix because I made so many errors on the inside. It has these things called transparencies, and I believe, you know, talking to GIMP, it crashed, and it left these, I don't know, false images, like a doubler. And so somehow I got the corrupted files. So I have corrupted file. And then I had to redo those. And then I'm like, well, this is cruddy. So I had to do that again. And so I made this little book, and it's there, and it's cute. It's so cute. But I redid I redid the character inside Cierno. I redid him. I put a skirt on him because he was controversial too much. And I'm like, well. And then I fixed Viona. I fixed Azalea. And who else did I do? I fixed Danserina one. So yeah. And then I fixed the cover itself. I fixed her skirt. I guess I made so many errors in my rush for this ridiculous holidays that. That I had to stop it and put in a new one, you know, so hopefully it's better, but I'm not going to do it again. I have two typos. I said fur dog, so it's a little more of this Slavic, goes straight to fur dog, and says instead of the fur of the dog, no, on the fur of the dog or something, I don't know, but I just went straight to fur dog, and there was another one I said about. And I left an S in. But that's interesting also, because that becomes from the Russian style, where they say about everything. About this, about that, you know. But, it can still be within the character of the speaking. But yeah, so there are words in there. Gosh dang it, I did not want to put a skirt on the dude, but I guess, you know, it is a children's book, and maybe they can't handle men in unitards, so I'm dealing with this odd, strange perplexion, you know, maybe children can't handle men in unitards, or boys in unitards, you know, so I have to clothe them all, put more and more clothes on. It's odd because I'm first drawing, I want to just draw them, you know, their form, and then not, and then I have to add all these clothes on, more and more clothes, but I guess that's the way of art.
Rar.
Yeah, so, I don't know, I did that, there was the photo mon. Well, I'll show you my little ISBN, it's there at the bottom. Now, I don't know, that's the lovebird, this one here. But, oh my god. Gosh. Yeah, Tarzan. I saw Tarzan. I'll mention him again. Apparently, there's two dudes maybe in the whole of the Bay Area that have long hair, and he was one of them. So it's interesting. Yeah, I went to that match.com and I filled out the form, and then I put in ballet, and there weren't very many men at all. And I'm like, well, maybe they're just people who go to ballet. So then I'm giving up. I'm giving up, and it's really, really a sad thing, isn't it? I'm just giving up on that. What do you call it? That plane. That plane of, because they're just, I don't know. They're so disappointing to me, actually. They're so disappointing to me because they don't fit into, you know, they have to fit into this category, they have to fit into that category, they have to fit in this one. I'm very, very selective, and so thusly, by being so selective, I've deselected myself, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah. Well, anyway. And then I made that photo montage deal, and that was kind of interesting. Yeah, I guess so. And what's else to say about it? I guess I don't know. I looked at the girls on that match.com. A few of them looked all right. So maybe they can fill the gap where I'm lacking in joining the party. I don't want to join the party with you guys. So many of you are just not, what do you call it? They're not on my wavelength. I'm like, well, that's just forget it. Just forget it. I'm just giving up. So many of you just don't, you're not even close to my wavelength. You don't understand me. And I'm like, well, the only one who's ever really going to understand me are like people that have been in ballet companies, you know? I just have so much of myself invested in ballet, you know? It's just ridiculous. So I have a really tiny limited market for finding a mate, you know. It's just ridiculous. And so we're looking at the performing arts. And then I even tried to expand myself and start singing opera, you know. Seeing opera expand, you know, and I'm like, oh, those guys are so heavy, and I'm like freaking out now. I'm having an opera freak out. Maybe that's why I don't want to sing anymore, because the guys are so heavy. Oh my god, what the heck? What the heck? So now I'm a coloratura who doesn't want to sing because the men who sing are too heavy. So now I'm broken. I'm just broken. Just like that. My Ubuntu had a broken pipe or whatever, an air pipe. Not a broken pipe. I don't think it was broken, but it was like a pipe air. And then it went took me down into the intravenous or whatever, the intraframus, the busy box. And I was stuck at busy box, and I'm like, oh God, this is awful. So I had to put reinstallation on it, and then just to get it back. And then somehow I cleared out, I went down to the FSCK, the EFSCK, or whatever that one is, I went into there, and I cleared out orphans. I had all of these little E-node orphans, and that is just hysterical. Yeah, I had like, I don't know, like 20 or something, but they were enough. They were enough to cause like everything needing everything back. I needed to bring the force pay back. I needed to bring all of these things back in to the install routine. And I'm like, gosh dang it. When this sucker crashes, it crashes because you're just like, uh-oh. I don't have like this, you know, major place to put all my files. And I'm like, why am I hoarding all these files again, you know? It's just awful. I hate it. It's because when I'm making these types of books, like here's gosh dang it, I don't think you can even see Clorinda. Here's Clorinda. When you're making Clorinda there, I'm making Clorinda, she needs, you know, I need to save her like in a really, really high resolution. So I think that's what crashed my computer, is I had such high resolutions that I went into the GIMP, and GIMP couldn't handle it. And maybe it's something to do with my swap, because I have one swap, what do you call it, on it. So that's really fun, yeah. So I'm giving up on men completely. Just, yeah, there's too many that are unattractive to me. Just too many. Yeah. Gosh dang it. I don't know. And I thought about, well, maybe a ballet matchmaker service. You know, maybe we make one for ballet. You know, for the dancers who were dancers. Because I think it's terrible. I think we are so, like, not compatible with the others that we're, like, freaks. You know, I just don't think we're normal people. I don't think we're normal people. When we started training when we were little children, we're freaks to them. I mean, you have to remember, they just went to like school. They just went to school. That's all they did. And they, you know, they like when they were 5 years old or whatever, and they had their teacher, and then they took a photo, and that's all they did. And then they maybe went to another school. You know, they didn't start performing. Yeah, and so when you're having like the performance group, yeah, I don't know. We need like to have some like performance network. I mean, it could be for Broadway people, it could be for the singers, and it could be for the dancers, you know. Ballet, you know. Yeah, what a hardship. So yeah. Cruddy. What a cruddy hardship is looking for. And then I'm like, I don't even want to be even... I mean, this is... I cannot believe it. And I'm like, well, I want to go back to Europe. Maybe if I go back to Europe. This is just awful, you know? And work in a company there. This is ridiculous. I'll be like one of those ballet mistresses or whatever. I'm not fitting in. I'm not fitting into these here U.S. states. Yeah. So anyway. Crud. Anyway, I know I got a little serious about Sophie there, a little bit. I don't know. I don't know. Nobody really talked to me about it, just a few people. And it was all just like, she killed herself or whatever. She died or she's dead or she committed suicide. And that's all I really heard. I didn't actually get any more, you know, what do we call it, info. Nobody knew any more info. So it's just one of those things that kind of like, you know, regs in your brain again and again, and the why, you know. And it really irks me because I was like, you know, so near to her, you know, for a long time before that, you know, before she killed herself, you know. I was like near to her every day, like in body proximity, you know. And I'm such like a cheerer upper type, you know, that's like who I am. I'm a cheerer upper type. And so it didn't help, you know. No, sometimes you can't get through to people. You know, I guess, you know, you can always say maybe it was her weight. Is, you know, she's worried about her weight or something. You can say that. It goes back to weight. You can say, you know, maybe we're all depressed about our weight. I mean, there were only three of us in that dressing room. Three. You know, she didn't have to kill herself. So when... Then I start thinking about, well, maybe she didn't, you know, maybe she didn't, you know, what's the proof? You know, maybe she didn't. Maybe she just said that or something. But that's not like her, you know, she wouldn't be just one who just said that. No. No, she wasn't like a false or a liar type ever. Just quiet undertone about her. Well, anyway. Yeah, so that's odd. It's odd. And I get the feeling that a lot of people, like, I don't know, resent me or something about it. Like, what was I supposed to call everybody for more information? Call on the telephone. Everybody in the company. You know, what happened? And after a while, I get the feeling, well, maybe nobody even cares. Maybe ballet is so mean. Maybe not one of you even cared about her. I mean, you knew I was right there next to her, sitting next to her, with our dirty tights and our point shoes for like a year. You knew I was there, and nobody called me. Now, one person called me and said, well, she killed herself, and nobody called me for an ask. Nobody called me. Nobody wanted to talk to me. I mean, do you disregard her that much? Do you disregard her life that much? Her person? It's just kind of sick. It's just like a sick group. And that's the group that I belong to. I belong to this sick group that didn't even want to even question me for a minute and say, hey, you know, did she say anything to you? I mean, I'm kind of peeved at every one of you that you've let this many years pass and you didn't contact me, you didn't call, you didn't ask. You know, what was your situation with her? I mean, I can't believe it. Don't you have queries in your brain? She was way too young. Anyway, I didn't mean to get bitchy, but so anyway, like I said, it's not there yet, and I'm still ordering proofs for this, the next one. So we'll see. It's done, and it's available at that Create Space. But yeah. I don't know. It's odd. It's odd that you all, and I say you all, I mean my dance world, all people, that you did not contact me and ask. You know, just want to talk to me about it. It's pretty rude. Oh God, it's a rude group. It's a rude, vicious group. You know, vicious. We're vicious. We're cold and we're discompassionate. For all that we have to give out there on the stage, I'm surprised there is anything to wretch out of your hearts for a moment. So discompassionate. All right, that was easy.